morning, everyone. This is Rajeshwari, working as assistant professor in St. Martin's Engineering College. Today, we would like to deal with the phonetics. Actually, many of us don't know when to speak English, actually proper sound. We cannot speak like a native speakers. So, if you want to speak like a native speakers, you have to learn phonetics. Phonetics actually it was established by IPA, International Alphabet Association. It has set up in 1888 and has devised and standardized representation of the phonetic sounds. So first of all, actually how the phonetics they made. So actually we have in English, we will see the introduction of the phonetics. So as we probably know, the phonetic symbols are a great help when it comes to learning to pronounce English words correctly. When you open a dictionary, you can find the correct pronunciation of words you don't know by looking at the phonetic transcription that follows the word. In English, as you certainly know, many words can have the same pronunciation but be written different with different meanings. For example, TO2 and TWO2, which all have the phonetic transcription 2 only. So if you observe a dictionary, you can find these two, TO2 and TWO2, which we have different meanings only, but we will get only phonetic transcription is 2 only. So we similarly, as we have in the OUGHE combinations also. So we can take the example of thought and truth. Thought and truth. So thought and OUGHE, if you refer to OUGHE combinations also, thought and true also we can observe in phonetics also. So first of all, we will see how they made IPA, International Phonetics Association, how they made phonetic sounds. We have in English alphabets, we have 26 letters. Out of these 26 letters, they made vowels and consonants. Vowels can be divided into, we have actually in phonetics, we have 44 sounds. These 44 sounds can be divided into two, vowels and consonants. Vowels 20 and consonants are 24. And these vowels can be divided into monophthongs and diphthongs. Monophthongs and diphthongs. These vowels can be divided into monophthongs and diphthongs. Monophthongs, we have 12 monophthongs. And we have 8 diphthongs also. Monophthongs, other name is pure vowels also. Consonants, we have 24 consonants. Before going to in detail phonetics, we have to know the what are the branches of phonetics. So branches of phonetics, we have acoustic phonetics. Acoustic phonetics means sounds which are the physical properties of the sounds. And auditory phonetics, the listener perceives, understands the sounds. And the next articulatory sounds, how we produce the sounds. So these are the three branches in phonetics. And before going to the phonetics, we must know the organs of speech. There are three groups of body organs which we use in the production of speech sounds. First one is respiratory system. First of all, 12 vowels, 12 pure vowels also. And suppose I will give examples also. We have front vowels. First, when we produce phonetic sounds, we will use the front of the tongue to produce these sounds. E, this is called E. When we transcript into phonetic transcription, scream, scream. And next, this is just E. When you make sound sit, kit, we can as in sit. A, get, pen, as in get pen. This is A, fan, van. So these are the front vowels. Next we will see the middle vowels. When we articulate the sounds with the middle vowels, middle of the tongue. So palm, as in palm, a woman, bird. Also, next we will go to the back vowels. Next, the back vowels we will produce with the back tongue. A, got, as in got. A, saw. Next, oo, good. Oo, foot. We will say, we just won't say foot. It is foot. And a, gun. We use back vowels like this. And first of all, when we go into the consonants, we must know the what is consonant. Consonant, when we articulate a sound, the air obstructed in the mouth and air cannot be released freely. First of all, we will see the manner of articulation and the place of articulation. Manner of articulation, it refers to the various articulators and the air still temporarily trapped and then released. And place of articulation, it refers to the main movements of the articulators. And first of all, we will see the manner of articulation. What is plosive? Plosive, when we articulate a consonant sound, the air obstructed in the mouth and it can be released slowly. Explosively. When next we have affricate, when we articulate a consonant, the air obstructed in the mouth and it can be released slowly. Cha and ja. Nostrils, which we pronounce with the nostrils. And next, affricate. Affricate is B sound that sounds like the word but functions as a consonant. And cha, cha is R. And next, we have a semi-vowel. A semi-vowel, it functions as a consonant, but it functions. functions as a vowel, but it sounds like a consonant only. And next, approximate, the articulators are not irritable but not close enough to produce friction, ur. And we have next, we will see the place of articulation. Place of articulation refers to the main movements of the articulators. Place of articulation, we have bilabial. Bilabial, a consonant articulated with the both the lips, p, b, m, and m. And next, we have labiodental, a consonant articulated with the upper lip and the lower lip, f and b. Next, dental, a consonant articulated with the upper lip and the lower lip, th and th. Next, we have alveolar, a consonant articulated with the teeth ridge and the tip of the tongue, tada and ss. Palatolar, a consonant articulated with the teeth ridge and while at the same time the front of the tongue is raised towards the hard palate, charja is ill. Next, we have palatal, palatal which associated with the front of the tongue as well as the back of the tongue. And next, we have hard palate. Next, we have glottal. Glottal is glottal, it sounds like a consonant, don't mean like a consonant only. We have ha, h, we generally we say h, this is that is ha. Next, we will see the consonants. Next we will see cha as in church, cha as in jacket, otherwise judge also. And next we have is, this is treasure, measure as in measure. And next this is tha as in tin, thought, true, all these we can make the sounds. And next we will go to the intersection. Next, diphthong, as I told you, exhalate of combination of two words, like, like, as in like. Next, here, let me say here also. And next, pure also. Pure and pure also we can write. So next we will see the next section. Thank you.